This is the Spitz AX from GL iNet, and it is an absolute beast of a mobile router. Now, you may know GL iNet from their pocket-sized travel routers, but the Spitz AX is a step above. It's ideal for semi-permanent setups like my RV here, or at a construction site, or a remote cabin, or even on a boat. And why, you ask? Well, it's because of the flexibility. This router offers a ton of WAN connectivity options, which means you're gonna have reliable internet no matter where you travel. Right now, I have the Spitz AX running a triple threat internet setup. We've got Starlink as primary, I'm using Wi-Fi as WAN as failover, and then finally, I have dual cellular SIMs as a third backup, all working together seamlessly. And I can modify the priority of these connections depending on my location and which internet options are available at any given place. In this video, I'm gonna show you everything that the Spitz AX has to offer, and we've got a lot to cover, so let's get started. Whether you're at home or if you're in an RV, sorting through all of the various types of firewalls, routers, and internet options can feel like trying to untangle Christmas lights. It's frustrating and it's time consuming. But it doesn't have to be. At Rogue Support, we specialize in making complex networking simple and stress-free. Whether you're setting up multiple internet connections or troubleshooting some dead spots in your Wi-Fi, the friendly technicians at Rogue Support are here to help. We'll design the perfect network for your needs, we're gonna recommend the best equipment for your deployment, and we're gonna solve any networking issues that you may be having. Getting started is easy. Just browse over to rogue.support and open up a ticket. And remember, you don't pay until your ticket is resolved. So give us a shot today and put your internet problems in the rearview mirror. You won't be disappointed. Let's take a look at the Spitz AX, starting with the ports. Around the back, we've got two RJ45 Ethernet ports. We've got a 2.5 gigabit WAN port and a 1 gigabit LAN port. We've also got a USB Type A port that can be used for either local storage with SMB, or it can be used to tether through your smartphone or LTE modem. If we open up this little cover on the side of the Spitz AX, we've got a micro SD card slot for even more storage capability, as well as dual 4G, 5G SIM card slots. That's right, this little router has dual cellular capability, which brings us to all of these antennas. Four of these antennas handle 4G and 5G signals, working with the dual SIM card slots to optimize your cellular reception. The other two antennas are for Wi-Fi 6, serving devices like phones or tablets, or for enabling Wi-Fi as WAN to connect to external wireless networks. The cool thing about the setup of these antennas is that they're flexible in their deployment. You can remove some or all of these antennas. For example, in an RV, the walls might be blocking signals, so I'd want to use an external antenna like this mobile mark here on the roof for better reception. This particular model has four cables for cellular and two cables for Wi-Fi. The cellular cables are pretty straightforward, but when it comes to using an external antenna for Wi-Fi, you've got a choice to make, right? Are you primarily picking up Wi-Fi as WAN from the exterior, or do you prefer to have your Wi-Fi for internal client devices? In my case, I'm gonna install this under the roof of my RV, and then I'm only gonna use the cellular cables to pick up 4G and 5G from the exterior. Now, this is an omnidirectional antenna, and omnidirectional antennas are great because they can pick up signals regardless of the orientation, which is ideal for RVs and vehicles. But for fixed locations like a cabin or a construction site, you might also consider a directional antenna such as this Waveform Quad Pro, which offers greater range because it can focus on specific towers. The point here is that you have flexible antenna options regardless of your deployment. If you already own an RV, you may already have an external cellular and Wi-Fi antenna up on top. Now, mine came with a WineGuard Air 360, which only picks up TV signals. But there is a WineGuard Air 360 Plus, which also has cellular and Wi-Fi capability. So always a good idea to check out what you already have before you actually invest in something new. Before I install this Spitz AX into my own RV, let's get it set up and ready. If you already have cellular SIM cards to install, do that before you power up the device, since the SIM cards are not hot swappable. You wanna screw in all of the various antennas and then boot it up. Once the Spitz AX powers on, connect to the default Wi-Fi SSID, which is GL-X300, plus the last three digits of the MAC address. You're gonna see both a 2.4 and a 5 gigahertz wireless network by default. The password is on the sticker underneath the router. Bring up the admin interface by browsing to 192.168.8.1 and you'll be prompted to choose your language and then set an admin password. Once you're inside the interface, you should see your SIM cards as well as any other internet connections that you have plugged in. In my case, I've plugged my Comcast cable connection into the WAN port, but I'm gonna replace that with Starlink once it's out in my RV. With two SIM cards installed, you can select which SIM is active or enable auto switch to prioritize one and then set a failover interval. Click on any of the WAN options at the top of the dashboard to get to the multi-WAN page where you can now adjust the priority for all of your connections. Now, personally, I like to prioritize Ethernet and then Wi-Fi as WAN or what's known as repeater mode, and finally cellular. Using cellular as a last resort minimizes any costs that might be associated with data caps or overage charges. You can also choose whether you want to do load balancing or failover for your multiple WAN connections. In most cases, failover is going to be fine, but if you have multiple unlimited connections, such as, you know, Starlink plus a campground's Wi-Fi as WAN, you might want to consider enabling load balancing. Now I can see that there's a little warning sign next to the system menu. This is because I haven't yet set the time zone for my router, so let's do that now. Click on System and then Time Zone. Pick your time zone and then click apply. The rest of these settings I'm gonna leave at their defaults, but this router offers some pretty advanced features such as VPN capability, tail scale or zero tier for remote access, as well as AdGuard Home for ad blocking. I've already done a full video on configuring the GL iNet Barrel AX travel router, which covers a ton of that stuff. And I'm gonna put a link down in the description of this video if you wanna go check it out. Next, we're gonna install the Spitz AX and this MobileMark antenna into my RV so that we can put everything that we've covered into action. The first thing I had to do was get the MobileMark antenna installed onto the roof. We built a custom base plate for it and made sure that it was completely sealed up and watertight. The cables were routed inside the RV right behind the TV here, and I wrapped them up in a piece of 1-inch cable organizer before I connected the cellular leads to the Spitz AX. Now, even though I'm not using them, I did also run in the Wi-Fi cables from the MobileMark antenna, and I just have them sort of tied up behind this TV here in case I do need to use them in the future. I also installed a cable cover down in the pass-through storage in the front of the RV so that I could route through the Ethernet and power for Starlink Mini, which is up on the roof. So now I have Starlink Mini plugged in with Ethernet to the WAN port of the Spitz AX, and I'm using the four cellular leads that are connected on the roof to the omnidirectional MobileMark antenna. Now I left the Wi-Fi antennas inside for all of my client devices, but I am also using Wi-Fi as WAN since I'm just parked in my front driveway here. So if you are at a campground with excellent Wi-Fi that can penetrate the walls of your RV, this is gonna work great for Wi-Fi as WAN, but otherwise I would just rely on Starlink with cellular as a backup. Inside the admin portal of the Spitz AX, I modified the Wi-Fi SSID and password so that they match what I have at home. That way, any devices that I bring with me when I travel will automatically connect to that same wireless SSID and password. The other setting that I configured was to change the activity lights on the Spitz AX so that they turn off at 10 p.m. and then turn back on at 7 a.m. You know, this router is mounted right next to the bed where I sleep in the RV, so it'll be nice not to have those green blinky lights going on all night while we're trying to sleep. Okay, so I have my three connections active. I have Starlink running from a Starlink Mini on the roof as primary. I have Wi-Fi as WAN connected to my house as a secondary. And then I have those two cellular SIMs as a tertiary internet connection or just a backup internet connection. So let's start by speed testing Starlink. We're gonna say go. And Starlink gave us 137 down by 14.8 up, which is actually pretty decent. Although Starlink does tend to fluctuate quite a bit, I usually see speeds between like 60 to 70 megabits all the way up to maybe 220 or so. So usually it falls somewhere in that range. It's not super consistent. Now I'm gonna unplug Starlink from the Spitz AX, and in the interface of the router, I can already see that Ethernet is now grayed out, meaning that it's not sensing that connection. I've relaunched the speed test application, and now it shows Comcast Business as the internet connection because it is connected with Wi-Fi as WAN to my house Wi-Fi that's right next to us here. So we're gonna say go. And Wi-Fi as WAN got us 174 by 128, which is, again, going from the Wi-Fi antennas inside the RV, outside the RV to pick up a wireless signal through the walls of my house. So that's actually pretty decent. So keep that in mind. If the campground where you're parked has decent Wi-Fi, you might want to prioritize their Wi-Fi even over Starlink if it seems like it's going to be more consistent. And so finally, I'm going to disable the Wi-Fi is WAN, and now we've defaulted back to our cellular connections. And if we look at our cellular stats, we can see that I have T-Mobile connected. Actually, both of my SIM cards happen to be T-Mobile, but I can switch between them by clicking that button right there, SIM 1 and SIM 2. They can also work as failover to each other. Typically, what you would want in an ideal situation is SIM cards from two different carriers. So you'll have, you know, T-Mobile and AT&T or Verizon or something like that. That way, you can pick which SIM card is gonna give you the best signal for the location where you happen to be parked. So bringing up the speed test application again, I can see that I am now connected to T-Mobile because it is using that cellular carrier. Let's go ahead and run a speed test. And remember, the cellular leads are connected to the antenna out on top of my RV, so it should have a pretty good non-obstructed signal, being that it's actually outside. And there we go for T-Mobile. We got 268 down by 34 up. So there you have it. This is the Spitz AX from GLINET. Now, whether you're on the road or at a remote cabin or managing some sort of semi-permanent deployment, this router offers tons of flexibility and reliability for your internet needs. I'd like to thank GLINET for sponsoring this video, and if you're interested in getting yourself a Spitz AX, there's a link down in the description that will get you 30% off, but only for a limited time. So act quick if you want to take advantage of that offer. Thank you so much for watching, and if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my full setup guide for the GLINET Beryl AX travel router, and the bottom video is my complete review of Starlink Mini.